Good morning.
Good morning, teacher.
How are you?
I'm fine.
Sleepy.
Sleepy. A little.
I know. What time do you go to bed?
5:30.
No. I mean, what time do you sleep?
Oh, 11 o'clock.
11. Ah, okay. It's similar to my case. I sleep at, let's see, 11:30 or sometimes 12.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. In my case, I have problems for sleeping. What about you?
Yeah. Yes. I have a little problem with get sleeping, but I have migraña.
Ay, migraine.
Migraine, yes.
Migraine. Mm-hmm.
Yesterday, all day.
Ay. Mm-hmm. And how do you feel today?
What? ¿Cómo?
How do you feel today? ¿Cómo se siente hoy? How do you feel today?
A little well.
Yeah. I know. And you have to go and work like that. Tiene que ir a trabajar así.
Sí.
You have to go and work like that.
Sí, aquí mismo en la casa. Después de la clase me quedo conectado. Uh-huh.
Ah, okay. You are home working from home.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. It is good working from home. It is good and it is bad. Yeah, in my case, I prefer to be in teaching personally. I mean, like before.
Yes.
Uh-huh, como antes, like before, but it is not possible. It is not possible in this moment that. Mm-hmm. Okay, everybody, good morning. Cruzando los dedos que no nos pase lo mismo de ayer. It was so terrible, right? The lights were off and on.
Good morning.
Good morning. Super chistoso, porque cuando lograba recuperar el internet, se volvía a apagar. La luz, I mean, not the internet, the electricity. But okay, today is a new day and I hope nothing happens. All right. Aunque estén unos poquitos, sorry. Aunque estén unos poquitos, we're gonna take the attendance right now. Let's see, Pablo Ernesto Campos.
Good morning, I hear.
Ah, Pablo is there. All right, very good. So the check. Hugo Ernesto Gil.
I'm here.
Here too. Juan González.
Present.
Sara Jacobo.
Good morning, I'm here.
Good morning. Okay, Connie Andres. She's not here yet. Connie Andres is not here yet. Let's see, Carlos Humberto Lima. Not here yet. Luis Fernando Linares. Not here yet. Okay, Nazareth Aide. Not here yet. Mejía Isabel. Not here yet. Okay. Ana Patricia Melara.
Present.
She's here. Carol Membreño. Rosa Irma Méndez.
Present.
Okay, Rosa Irma is here. Danilo Morales. Nelson Quintanilla. Erwin Rivera. Raquel Sierra.
Good morning.
Hi, Raquel Sierra. Good morning. She's here. Okay, so give me a second. You are twice. Andrea Ticas.
Present.
And Jose Roberto Vázquez.
Good morning.
Good morning. Very good. Excellent. So I'm going to save the changes and I'm going to stop this. Well, yesterday, we're gonna begin again the class. Bueno, gracias a Dios que no habíamos avanzado mucho. We're gonna continue with the class from yesterday, right? And we're gonna begin, well, we have here the objectives, right? We were talking about that we were going to write reputation of the company and et cetera. Okay, right now, ahorita vamos a hacer una pequeña, dinámica, right? We're gonna play a little game, and the name is categories. La categorías, categories. Okay, for example, imagine if I say, give me a second. Imagine if I say colors. Okay, what colors can you tell me that you know? What colors can you tell me that you know?
Blue.
Pink. Okay, another.
Black,
very good.
Yellow.
Green, okay.
Sky blue.
Red.
Purple.
Orange.
Gray.
White,
very good. No more?
Brown,
very good. No more? So we have blue, pink, black. Okay, how do you say in English plateado?
Silver,
very good. That's plateado in English. How do you say in English dorado?
Golden.
You can say gold or golden, but not the beer, right?
Gold.
but not the beer. Okay.
Good morning.
It's the same. I mean, people say golden light because of the color. Le llaman a la cerveza así por el color. All right? But it's the same. Es lo mismo. It's the same. Okay. What else? No more? How do you say in English beige?
Beige.
Yeah, it is similar. All right, very good. Then we have turquoise. All right, that's another color, turquoise. And the pronunciation is turquoise. All right. Okay. Let's see. We have blue, pink, black, yellow, green. I think we have all the colors. Okay, what about if I say, porque esto no va a servir después. All right, what about if I say food? What can you tell me? What vocabulary can you tell me related to food?
Chicken,
very good. What else?
Pizza.
Meat. Juan Jose, what did you say?
Rice.
Excellent.
Beans.
Ah, yes. Salvadorian. This is Salvadorian diet. A must. All right. What else?
Salad.
Very good. Salad.
Vegetables.
Do you like vegetables? Vegetales, do you like vegetables?
Yes.
All right.
Potatoes. Whiskey is whiskey, all right? We don't have a translation of that in English. We have corn, but not the group, etc. Okay, what else?
Spaghetti,
very good. Spaghetti, what else?
Hamburger.
Pancakes. Do you like pancakes in the morning? Or you prefer three pupusas?
So.
Okay, yeah, because imagine if you have pupusas and pancakes, what do you prefer?
Pupusas,
all right. But imagine the pancakes have chocolate and strawberries. Pupusas. Okay, what else?
Eggs,
very good. Eggs. How do you say huevos estrellados in English? Do you know?
No idea.
No? Okay, you say sunny eggs. Sunny eggs. All right, very good. Sunny like the sun. Porque tienen como forma de sol, all right? Sunny eggs. And huevos estrellados are scrambled eggs. Yes, okay. Another food item. Tell me more. Sorry?
Hot dogs.
Choris. Okay. What else? I have a question. Do you like choris?
Absolutely.
Ah, yes. Okay, very good. Yeah, and how many choris do you eat? Do you normally eat?
Two.
Okay, very good. And when you are really hungry, three.
Yeah, three.
Ah, okay, very good. Okay, tell me another food item.
Sandwich,
very good. What else? Oh, you have chicken, pizza, meat, rice, beans, salad, vegetable. Okay.
Cereal.
All right, very good. Cereal. That's okay. Okay, with food. All right, we're gonna go to the next one. And the next one will be fruits. Okay, very good. Fruits, the category of fruits. Now, tell me some fruits that you like.
Strawberry.
Okay, very good. Strawberries.
Watermelon.
Pineapples. Watermelon.
Watermelon.
Kiwi.
Kiwis. Do you like kiwis?
Yes.
Okay. In my case, I don't like kiwis. I think that maybe because of the semilla, the seed, sometimes it's very amarga, very bitter. Mm-hmm. Okay, tell me another.
Bananas.
Sorry. Oh, bananas. Banana. Yeah, because watermelon is there.
Grapes.
Yeah, green or purple?
Green.
Okay, very good. Green grapes. Okay, what else?
Apples.
Oranges,
all right. No more fruits.
Fish.
Oh, la licha.
No, fish.
Ah, peach. That was la licha. Yeah, because la licha also has a name in English. You call it rambutan. Rambutan. Rambutan es el famoso mamón peludo, mamón chino. So in English, you call it rambutan. Jocote is mung bean. So in plural is mung beans. Okay?
Mangoes.
Yeah, mangoes are very delicious. Mangoes. Okay, what else? Oh yeah, mung beans, mangoes. How do you say in English, everybody, mandarina? Do you know or no?
No.
I don't know.
All right. Those are the tangerines. Tangerines. Yeah. Tangerines. That's the name. Tangerines. Okay. Tell me three more fruits. Three more fruits.
Lemon.
Lemons. Yeah. Lemons are fruits. What else?
Strawberry.
Oh, we have strawberries. You told me strawberries, number one.
Coconuts.
All right. And one more. How do you say in English, everybody? Cerezas.
Cherry.
Okay. So in plural, cherries. All right. Yes. Yeah, cherries or cherries. That's the pronunciation. Okay. Okay, vamos a una más. One more. Let's see. The last one is gonna be movies. Movie names. All right, very good. Movies. Okay, so tell me the name of movies, but in English, not in Spanish, in English.
The Avengers.
Ay, The Avengers. Very good. That's a nice movie. All right. Very good. The Avengers. What else?
The Conjuring.
Uy, The Conjuring. Very good. Yes. What else?
The Lord of the Rings.
The Lord of the Rings. Okay. Another?
The Soul.
So, very good. So, that's a nice saga. What else?
The Notebook.
Ay, that's nice. That's very romantic. The Notebook. What else?
The Shooter.
The Shooter. That's a nice one too.
A Walk to Remember.
A Walk to Remember. All right, very good. In Spanish, what's the name of that movie?
Un amor para recordar.
No, oh really? Is it good?
Yes.
did you cry?
Yes.
Okay, so you were emotional with the movie. Okay, another.
Spider-Man.
Spider-Man. Well, another.
Paranormal Activity.
Oh, sorry.
Paranormal Activity.
Okay. The other. Fast and Furious. All right. Lion King.
Marley and Me.
That is a good movie. Marley and Me. Okay. Another?
Click.
Click from Adam Sandler is good. Okay, what else?
Cars,
all right, animated movie.
The Lone Jar.
Oh, that is a good movie. That is a good with Adam Sandler.
Yeah.
That he is in prison and he plays American football.
Yeah.
That's a good movie, yeah. The Long Yard. Yes. Okay, another.
Finding Nemo.
Very good. Okay, we're gonna stop over there. That's it. Okay, nice. Now, listen what we're gonna do with this vocabulary. What we're gonna do with this vocabulary is we're gonna ask questions. For example, ¿qué preguntas podríamos hacer con colors? Con la categoría de colors. What questions? ¿Qué possible questions can we ask?
What color?
What is your favorite color?
Okay, very good. It's like the most common, right? What's your favorite color? Very
what
easy.
What color for this?
Okay, sorry. What color do you like? Me dijo alguien por ahí también. All right, another?
What color is your car?
Oh, what color is your car? All right, there you, or we can say, what's your car's color? All right, very good. It's the same. What's your car's color? What is your car's color? Okay, another question, another possible question. Podemos preguntar también de algo que no nos gusta. For example, what colors don't you like? Okay, very good. All right. Esta cosa me borra todo. All right. What questions can we ask with food? What possible questions can we ask for food?
Pizza?
Ah, okay. Do you like very specific questions? All right. Do you like pizza? Do you like chicken? ¿Y cómo se contestan esas preguntas? Por ejemplo, si alguien me pregunta a mí.
Yes, I like it.
Ah, very good. We say, yes, I like it. I like it. Or no, I don't like it. Si usted contesta solo, yes, I like, siempre va a faltar como alguito. Entonces es ese it. Ese it es a lo que uno hizo referencia antes. For example, do you like chicken? Yes, I like it. Y ese it es para no volver a repetir la palabra chicken. Is it clear? Yeah, okay. Another question here. What things we can also ask? What things do you like eating for lunch? How do you say almuerzo?
Lunch.
Lunch. How do you say desayuno?
Breakfast.
How do you say cena?
Dinner.
Very good. Dinner. We say dinner. So lunch, breakfast, and dinner. I'm gonna write it like this. Here. I'm gonna write it here. Sorry. Okay. So we say lunch, breakfast. The first food in the morning. Lunch. And dinner. Okay, very good. Breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Okay, what questions can we ask with fruits? What questions can we ask with fruits? Porque ya vamos a ir a practicar. Entonces estamos recolectando preguntas para ir a preguntar, all right? Valga la redundancia. Okay, so we're collecting questions, so we go and we practice. Tell me more questions.
Do you like bananas?
Okay, very specific questions, right? Do you like, and you say, do you like? Specific questions. Another question, everybody? No more questions.
What fruit do not you like?
Excellent, very good. What fruits don't or do not, like Pablo said, what fruits do not or don't you like? Okay.
What is your favorite fruit?
Okay, very good. What's your favorite fruit? Excellent. What's your favorite fruit? Etc. Okay, we're gonna leave it there. What about with the questions with movies? What questions can we ask? What questions can we ask with movie?
What is your favorite movie?
Okay, very good. What's your favorite movie? All right, another.
What do you like movies, son?
Sorry, can you repeat, please?
What do you like? Movie, the Avenger.
Why? Excellent, uh-huh. Excellent. Why do you like? And we mentioned the movie, right? For example, my favorite movie is. ¿Quién fue la que me dijo esta pregunta?
Nazareth.
Okay, vaya. I will mention my favorite movie, and you ask me this question. Okay, all right. Nazareth, my favorite movie is John Wick.
Why? What do you like?
John Wick? Okay, I like John Wick, number one, because Keanu Reeves is my favorite actor. And number two, because the movie is fantastic and it has a lot of action. And blah, 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 okay? Uh-huh, that's okay. Why? Okay. All right, para contestar una pregunta de why, ¿por qué? You say because, all right? Very good, because.
Okay.
Because I like it, because it is nice, all right? Because mm-hmm. it is fantastic. You can answer any question, any way. All right, I'm gonna give you more. Who's your favorite actor? Cuando usted dice la palabra actor, ahora ya incluye también a las mujeres. ¿Ok? Así que si usted pregunta, who's your favorite actor? You can answer with the name of a woman. Okay?
Okay.
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 Please, everybody, take a picture porque ahora vamos a ir a la práctica, all right? We're gonna practice. All right, ya nos armamos de vocabulario de preguntas, hoy vamos. All right, do you have a question? ¿Como alguna pronunciación? Do you have a question with pronunciation? For example, how do you pronounce this?
No.
El mamón peludo or el mamón chino, how do you pronounce that? ¿Cómo lo pronunciamos? We pronounce it rambutan.
Rambutan.
En jocotes, mom beans. Okay? Mom beans are jocotations. Jocotes, all right? Mom bean. Okay. Did you take a picture?
Yes.
Okay, very good. Remember, acuérdese, cuando usted va al mini room, usted puede proyectar la foto. Solo le da abajo a donde dice, ¿saben cómo compartir la foto? Do you know?
Yes.
Yes, y sí, está habilitado para que usted comparta. All right, very good. Okay, let me see. Quiero ver si está habilitado. Yes, share a screen. Okay, available. Now I'm gonna make the small groups. Vamos a hacer los pequeños grupos, grupos de tres para que practiquemos. Okay. So you can ask any question and you can practice. All right, and we will go right now. Okay, let's go to the practice number one.
Rotando cada cuántos, nos dividimos cinco o cómo? Sí, yo digo que cinco sale bien, cinco colores cada uno y luego cinco comidas.
Ajá, claro, porque no creo que nos alcance el tiempo.
Va, démosle entonces.
Yes.
What's your favorite color, Pablo?
My favorite color is black.
Ok. Ok, Nazareth, ¿verdad?
Yes, my favorite.
Se ve.
Sí, sí. Sí, se ve.
Sí, yo igual.
A ver. Dios mío, ¿y qué estoy haciendo? Espérenme. Vaya, entonces, no sé quién empieza.
actor?
Chris Evans.
Me too. He is my husband. Yeah, he's very handsome.
He's my boyfriend.
Ah, okay. He's my husband and he's your boyfriend. Okay, yeah.
Yes.
It is good to compartir. It is good to share. Okay. We almost finished in 10 seconds, all right? So we're going back. Okay, everybody. All right. Now I would like you to practice the questions, okay? I would like you to practice the questions with me, okay? Ask me questions. One person. Yes, Jose Roberto.
Oh, okay. What's your favorite color?
My favorite color. It is very ironical because not everybody likes this color, but I love this color.
Orange,
yes. Orange is one of my favorite colors.
Okay. What color don't you like?
What colors I don't like? Well, it is difficult because I like all colors.
Okay.
I like all colors. I don't have a problem with white or black or gray. No. Well, I love black too.
Okay.
Yes.
Yes. Listo.
Okay. Thank you, Roberto. Another person? Carol.
Teacher.
Oh, Pablo. All right, Pablo. Ask me a question.
Hoy ya no voy manejando, así que voy a poner más atención.
Okay. Very good. No problem.
Teacher, do you like meat?
Meat? Yes, I do, but it's not my favorite.
Ah, okay.
Mm-hmm. I prefer chicken.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
What things do you like eating for lunch?
What things do you like eating for lunch? I love eating chicken soup. I love it. And I like salads or vegetables.
Yes. I don't like pollo campero chicken.
Do you like pollo? Yes, I like pollo campero chicken, but the problem is that if I eat pollo campero chicken, I have a problem. Okay, thank you, Pablo. Thank you very much. Another person?
What color don't you like?
Oh, I don't have a problem with colors. I like all colors.
Okay, all right.
Yes. Okay, one more.
Do you like horror movies?
Oh, okay, Ana Patricia, right. Okay, Ana Patricia, and after that, Raquel. Ana Patricia, I don't like horror movies. No.
I am Raquel.
Raquel.
This is my question.
Sorry, okay. I like it.
You like horror movies?
Also. I like it.
Okay. Yes, you like it. All right. Very good. You like it. All right. Ana Patricia, ask me the question, please.
Do you like mangoes with lemon?
Yes. I love mangoes with lemon, but you know, not green mangoes. No, because... I prefer yellow mangoes, like, for example, in March, when you go to La Costa del Sol, right? And they sell the mango, like in the shape of a flower. Sazón. Yeah. Sazón, yeah. It is, sazón in English is like a kind of ripe, ripe. Because okay. I'm going to show you. Maduro in English is ripe. Okay, maduro is ripe in English. And like this, ya se los escribo, como se escribe maduro. Okay, very good. Pero si usted dice mango sazón, a ripe mango, eso significaría como mango maduro. Pablo, yes, you have a question.
Yes, quería preguntar que cuando son nombres propios así de empresas, es, así como le decía Pollo Campero, ¿se pronuncia siempre el nombre Pollo Campero? O se dice chicken y después campero.
Ah, ok, very good, very good. En este caso podríamos traducir, right? Así entre comillas, porque los nombres se deben de dejar así tal cual están, right? Pero yeah, we can make a translation, but we have to be more specific. We have to say campero chicken restaurant, all right? Campero chicken restaurant. That's what we have to say. We have to be very specific. Is it clear?
Ah, okay.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yeah, yeah, very good, very good. Okay, si nosotros queremos traducir la palabra sazón al inglés, se van a encontrar varias traducciones, por ejemplo, seasoning, pero eso ya es sazón de condimento, okay? So, if you want to say, for example, que el mango está medio maduro, entonces vamos a usar esta palabra que es ripe, pero con una palabra que indique que está más o menos maduro. Entonces, más o menos in English, no se dice, hay gente que dice more or less or so-so, pero es más común escucharlos decir kind of, kind of. Entonces usted dice kind of ripe mango. ¿Ok? ¿Es clear? ¿Está difícil?
Soso.
Poquito. Escríbalo, write it down if you have a notebook, right? So you say mango maduro, ripe mango. Mango medio maduro, kind of ripe mango. Ok, con esta palabra acostúmbrense bastante, porque, por ejemplo, cuando yo les pregunte, everybody, do you like, for example, do you like bananas? Kind of, teacher, kind of. Ahí está diciendo más o menos, ¿ok?
Ok, kind of.
Very good. Nunca, nunca, a los que les gustan las canciones en inglés, nunca han visto esta palabra en las letras, si la leen. ¿No?
Sí.
Ah, ok, yeah. Very good. Vaya, esa palabra significa más o menos, kinda, 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 I feel, por ejemplo, usted quiere decir, ay, me siento más o menos triste, porque no me dieron nada el 14 de febrero. All right, so you say, I feel kinda, kinda sad, kinda sad. Pero esa es la como la contracción informal, all right? Lo formal de decir sería, I feel kind of sad, okay? I feel kind of sad. All right, that's what we will say. I feel kind of sad. Yeah, okay. Ana Patricia, ask me the last question. La última pregunta, the last question.
Do you like sandwich in the morning?
Sandwiches in the morning, yes. Yes, I do. I don't have any problem with sandwiches in the morning. Yes. All right. Okay. Thank you very much. Now I'm going to erase this and we will continue. Let's see. And all right. We're going to work with a little exercise that is related with adjectives. Vamos a seguir aprendiendo adjetivos. All right. So I'm going to click here. All right. And we're going to go to internet right now. All right. Uy. Sorry. Is here. All right. Now, here we have a little exercise. All right. This is a website that is very, give me a second. Okay. Very good. So here we have some pictures and we have the two options here. We have to select the correct option. For example, here, what is the option here? Hot or cold?
Hot.
Okay, correct. Very good. Correct. What about here?
Slow or fast?
Yes, very good. Y si quisiéramos decir una oración, ¿cómo lo vamos a decir?
The rabbit is fast.
And remember, verb to be, adjectives.
The animal is fast.
Okay, very good. Yeah, you can say the animal is fast. Excellent, very good, excellent. The next one. The next one is, okay. Yay! Poor is like the, for example, yeah. I don't for have one, me. all people in El Salvador, right? Yeah, because we don't have a lot of money. Okay. Poor, but rich is the opposite. The next one.
Young.
Okay, listen to the pronunciation. Young.
Young.
Look at me. Young.
Young.
We don't say young, no. Young. I'm going to tell you why. Because if you say young, es como que lo estoy diciendo con esta letra. Okay? Vaya, ¿cómo decimos? How do you pronounce esta palabra? ¿Cómo pronunciamos? ¿Cómo decimos sí in English?
Yes.
Exactly. Ya les escuché bien, bien nice. You don't say yes. You say yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yes. All right. Very good. Para decir color amarillo.
Yellow.
Exactly. Yellow. It's yellow, not yellow. Because if you say yellow, está diciendo gelatina. Okay. So amarillo, yellow. Joven.
Young.
Very good. Excellent. And this is the option. Very good. Young. Okay. What about the next one?
Fat.
Fat. Very good. Fat. Excellent. You say fat. Like with a smile. Fat. What about the next one?
Easy.
Easy.
Yeah, very good. You say easy. Okay, the next one.
Big.
Excellent. I have a question. Do you like big breakfast or small breakfast?
Big breakfast.
You like big breakfast?
Or no,
yes.
Small.
Or a small, only one sandwich and that's all.
Yes.
Or you like four pupusas, a lot of curtido. Okay, very good. The next one.
Soft.
Suave, soft?
Soft.
Yes, because this one is duro, hard.
Hard.
Hard, all right, very good. También puede, esta palabra, hard, también puede significar difícil. Okay, hard, all right. The next one.
Teacher.
Yes, Pablo.
Y soft también se puede decir que es tranquilo.
Good question. No, porque eso se refiere a textura. Pero si usted quiere decir que alguien es tranquilo, así como el modo suave quiere decir usted.
Ajá, que a veces he escuchado que dicen, hoy va a estar bien soft.
¿El cómo?
A veces he escuchado que dicen, hoy va a estar bastante soft, o hoy está bien soft.
Ah, vaya, pero eso es con respecto a la carga de trabajo, me imagino, ¿verdad? O whatever.
Ajá.
Pero si es persona, podemos decir que la persona es kind. All right. The meaning of kind is amable. We can say, oh, she's kind. She's gentle. All right. Ella es gentil o él, right? Gentle. All right. Let's see. She's nice. Para persona sería esto. Okay. But soft. Okay. Yeah, but soft. It can be for example, you can touch the arm of your girlfriend and my girlfriend has soft skin or something like that, or soft hair, something like that. Okay, very good. What about the next one? Beautiful or ugly?
Beautiful.
Beautiful. All right, very good. Okay, the next one.
Buenos días.
Good morning. Good morning. Cheap or expensive? Bueno, no sé si me dijeron a mí. All right. Cheap or expensive?
Expensive.
Expensive.
Expensive. And what's the meaning of expensive?
Caro.
Caro. Very good. Something expensive, right? For example, Puma. Nike. And Homa. Homa o Bracos. They are cheap. Or Serena sandals, la chancleta Serena, right? They are cheap. Okay, very good. Yes. Okay, very good. Okay, the next one. ¿Cómo se llaman las de hule? Las chancletas de hule, I forgot.
Balco.
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 Balco, yeah, Balco sandals. Eran buenas, vean. De todos usamos chiquitos de eso. Okay,
no,
what
about para correr, ¿no?
Ah, no, para no, para correr, no.
Suave chapina, pues, se ocupa.
¿Cuál?
La suave chapina. Así
se llama. Ah, okay. Pero duran más que una de marca, right? Okay. What about the next one? Good or bad?
Good.
Good. All right, very good. What about the next one? Long or short?
Long.
Long. How do you say cuchillo? Cuchillo. How do you say cuchillo?
No.
Knife. Knife. Very good. Ahorita se los escribo. Knife. Okay. Knife. Y el plural hay que aplicar una regla. Cuando la palabra termina en F-E o F, vamos a hacer esto para escribirla en plural. V-E-S. No sé si se pueden esas reglas. No.
No.
No. Ok. Ah, all right. Las de plural y singular. Mañana vamos a ver si las repasamos, ¿ok? Very good. Yo sé que hay algunos que tal vez algunas cositas no las sabemos. Entonces voy a ver si al principio de la clase les meto alguito de eso. All right. Para que vayamos aprendiendo. Porque esto es bien importante saberlo. Cómo escribir las cosas. For example, cherry. ¿Se fijaron cómo la escribí? Do you remember? Did you pay attention? Ah, cherries. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, pero mire esta palabra que viene acá. Termina también en Y, right?
Mm-hmm.
Pero ¿cuál es el plural? Mire cuál es el plural. Mm-hmm. Y cherry, ¿por qué en la que está antes que es Y le puso IES y en la que está abajo que tiene puso S? Vaya, esa regla le puedo explicar, ¿ok?
Ok.
Okay, very good. So, but knife, the plural of knife is knives. So here we have two knives, but one knife is everybody
long.
Two?
Long.
And the other knife is
short.
Very good. One knife is long and the other knife is short. Okay, very good. Knife, long knife and short knife. Okay, the next one.
Clean.
Very good. Clean. And the next one.
Happy.
Very good. Very good. Okay. Now, vamos a hacer uno más para ir aprendiendo más. Esta página es on internet, all right? This is an internet page. De aquí les puedo dejar ejercicios también para practicar. Y están fáciles y rápido, all right? Very good. Let's go with the next one. Okay. Ahora vamos a ver el opuesto, okay? From de los anteriores. We're gonna see the opposite. Okay. So, which is this one?
Cool.
What about here?
Low.
All right. What about the next one?
Poor.
How do you say in English? Él es un hombre pobre.
He's a poor man.
He is a poor man. Very good. He is a poor man. Okay, very good. The next one.
Old.
Parece huevo el señor, ¿verdad? Okay. Yes, like the, I don't know if you have watched the movie Alice in Wonderland. Alicia en el País de las Maravillas. Have you watched that movie?
Ay, sí, de, es cierto. De
igualito, mire, pero ya viejito. All right, very good. The next one. Uy.
Thin.
Thin. Dice, mira el pobre ahí. All right, thin. What's the next one?
Short.
Okay, very good. Short. The next one.
Weak.
Just remember John Wick. All right, very good. So, but John Wick is weak. Este es un poquito weak. Más largo el sonido. Weak. All right. So yes, it's weak.
What is weak?
Weak.
Ah, the meaning. All right. The meaning of weak is débil.
Okay.
Débil. All right. Very good. Pero débil de que no tiene mucha fuerza o también que no se sabe defender. All right, okay. Very good. A weak person. Yeah, the next one.
Difficult.
Yes, yo no lo entiendo. ¿Quién lo entiende aquí en from this class? Do you understand this?
It's a garabato.
Yes. Yeah, it is difficult. Yeah, I don't understand. I only know that 2 + 2 = 4. The next one.
Ugly.
Very good. Ugly. Yeah, the pronunciation. Aunque tengamos una U, pero va a sonar como A. Ugly.
Ugly.
All right. Very good. The next one.
Hard.
Hard. Very good. Hard. The next one.
Sad.
Sad. Poor face. Yeah, está tristita la cara. The next one.
Small.
All right, very good. Small. And the next one.
Bad.
All right. And the next one.
Dirty.
Okay, you can say dirty, sucio, or you can pronounce it dirty.
Dirty.
Yeah, you can say dirty. Clean or dirty. All right, very good. And vamos a hacer el último, all right, the last one. Okay. Se pueden bastantes adjetivos, right? Yeah. O si no, nos vamos a ir familiarizando. Okay, go ahead. Look at that.
Hungry.
Hungry.
Okay. It's correct. Hungry is correct. Now, ¿con qué palabra lo solemos confundir in pronunciation?
Angry.
Very good. So, vamos a dejar la diferencia clara. Hambriento is hungry. En enojado is angry. Okay? Hungry. Hungry is hambriento. Angry is enojado. Is it clear?
Yes.
Yeah, but imagínese que usted dice, I'm not teacher, I am hangry. Hangry or angry, yeah, you have to make the difference. Hungry, angry. Okay, the next one. Which is the next one?
Fool.
Fool. And what's the meaning of fool?
Lleno.
Very good. Nice. The next one.
New.
Yes, new. What about the next one?
Quiet.
Okay, the pronunciation is quiet.
Quiet.
Very good. Quiet. Nice. The next one.
Quiet.
The meaning of quiet is callado. And the other, el otro que está ahí, noisy, is the opposite, ruidoso. Yeah? Okay, very good. The next one.
High.
Alto. Pero estamos hablando de altura, right? High. What about the next one?
Clever.
Silly es tonto. Clever is listo.
Okay, clever.
Very good, clever. It is a synonym. ¿De qué palabra es sinónima? Una que ustedes ya se pueden. Inte. Intelligent. Intelligent. Very good. Intelligent. Nice. Excellent. Okay. The next one. What's the meaning of what's the meaning of thirsty? Thirsty.
Sediento.
Very good. And the pronunciation. La pronunciación sería como así. I will show you. Thirsty. Thirsty. Mm-hmm. Así como con la Z en español. All right. Thirsty. Thirsty. All right. Very good. Thirsty. Okay. And hungry is the hambriento. Right? So this one is thirsty. Very good. Thirsty. What about the next one? What about the next one?
With
quiet.
Quiet. All right. Very good. Sorry. Narrow or wide. Wide. The meaning of wide is ancho. Okay. Wide. Very good. Y el otro es angosto. Okay. What about this one?
Angry.
Angry. Very good. Angry. And what about the next one? Oh, friendly. What's the meaning of friendly?
Amigable.
Friendly is amigable. Very good. Very amistoso, amigable. Que le gusta ser amigos. All right. The next one. Wet. Very good. Wet. Okay. Very good. Wet. And mojado, right? And the opposite is seco, dry. What about the next one? Ya nos faltan poquitos. The next one.
Heavy.
Heavy. Very good. And the opposite, light. Here, ocupado, busy, or haragán, lazy.
Lazy.
Very good. All right, lazy. What about the next one? Rude or kind?
Kind.
Amable, kind?
No.
It is rude. All right. ¿Cómo dirían ustedes? Esa niña es pesada.
Rude. Luna.
Yeah, that girl is rude. All right, very good. That girl is rude. Very, very, very rude. That girl is rude. Okay, and what about the last one?
Dangerous.
Yeah, but she has a nice face. All right, very good. She has a gentle face, nice face. Okay, very good, everybody. Excellent. All right. Now we're going to the next activity. Y son unas preguntas, all right? They are some questions. But aquí, estas preguntas no se pueden contestar, yes or no, porque les doy dos opciones para cada pregunta. So, for example, in the first question, José Roberto, can you please read the first question?
Okay. Are elephants big or small?
Okay, everybody, thank you, Jose Roberto. What do you think, everybody?
The elephant speaks.
Ah, okay. Or you can say, they, si no quieren volver a repetir, the elephants, all right? You can say, they, porque usamos they y no it. What do you think?
Plural.
It's.
Plural. Very good. Okay. Very good. Elephants is plural. For that reason, you say they. ¿Y qué verbo vamos a usar?
Are.
So you say they are big. Y ahí está la respuesta. Y así va a ser para la mayoría. Most. Let me see. Okay. En preguntas como... I will show you. En preguntas como is music relaxing or stressing? Is love necessary or unnecessary? Air is a Salvador peaceful or dangerous? In here, aquí ya no podemos contestar they are. Because music is singular. Love is singular. and El Salvador is singular. So we're gonna say it is. It is. Y usted menciona la opción que escoja. Is clear? Is it clear?
Okay. Yeah.
For example, le voy a hacer una pregunta. Is reggaeton nice or ugly?
Ugly.
It's ugly.
It's ugly.
Ah, ugly. So it's you're going to say it is.
Ugly. It is ugly.
It is ugly. It is
ugly.
Okay, another. Is salsa music nice or bad?
It is nice.
Nice.
Okay, it is.
It is nice.
Ajá. Con este it is, usted está diciendo en español esto, mire. Bien chistoso, porque con dos palabras dice lo que una palabra dice en español. Es. Sorry, because. Okay. I'm gonna write it here. And we say is. When you say it is, ahí está diciendo es. Mm-hmm. Okay, so let me see another question. Is pizza delicious or not delicious?
It is delicious.
They are delicious.
It is. All right, pizza. Pizza se toma como singular. Mm-hmm. So you say it is. Is pizza delicious or not delicious? Delicious. Okay. Is chocolate delicious or not delicious?
It is delicious.
It is delicious.
Very good. Entonces, las preguntas que tengan corazoncito se van a contestar con it is y usted escoge la opción que quiera. Pero las otras que llevan are, or, para hacerlo más fácil, vaya, I'm going to make it easier. Questions, preguntas con are, questions with are, the answer is they are. Questions with is, the answer is it is. Okay?
Okay.
Okay.
Very good. Please take a picture porque vamos a ir a otra práctica hablada, right? Another speaking activity. Speaking activity. Okay, and you let me know. You got it? You have the picture?
Yes.
Yeah, very good, very good. Okay, well, vamos a practicar. We're gonna practice. But, espérame, vamos a, I'm gonna recreate the rooms. Sí, podemos practicar en parejas. Yeah, that's good. All right, very good. Okay, let's go.
Our mother, I don't know. Our mother lovely or strip?
Lovely.
Okay.
Sorry. The complete answer. They are. They are lovely.
Okay.
Okay, very good. Yeah, that's okay. Solo para practicar, pero sí se puede solo contestar lovely, right? Pero para practicar, we can say they are lovely. All right?
Okay,
okay. Continue. Nice, nice. Hugo, you lost connection.
Hola, se me desconectó.
Tranquilo, vaya, lo voy a mandar a otro grupo, no con la compañera que estaba, porque la moví, para que no se quedara solita, ¿ok?
De acuerdo.
Vamos a ver, okay. Lo voy a mandar, con José lo voy a mandar, José Roberto, porque se le fue el internet a otro quizás. Okay, very good. Okay, very good, everybody. Now we are gonna ask the questions. Now, well, we're gonna begin with Juan Jose. Juan Jose, you're gonna be my volunteer victim.
Okay.
Okay. Choose one question. Select one question and ask the question to one of your classmates, okay?
Okay. Are cats clean or dirty?
Okay, and the classmate?
Sara Jacobo.
Sara, okay.
Hello.
Okay, Juan Jose, repeat the question, please.
Are cats clean or dirty?
They are dirty.
All right. Very good, Sara. Sara, choose one question and ask another classmate, please.
Okay. Jose Roberto.
Okay.
Hi.
Are men loyal or disloyal?
No sé por qué pensé que iba a preguntar eso. Yeah.
Depends. In my opinion, they are loyal.
They are.
Yes.
They are, Jose, or we are?
We are. We are loyal.
Aha, because if you say they are, it's like they are.
We are loyal.
You are loyal, sure.
Yes.
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 100% sure.
What?
100% sure. 100% seguro, 100% sure.
Yes.
Ah, okay, very good. All right, Jose, choose a question and ask another classmate.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm going to tell you, ¿tú los puedes ver a todos o solo mi pantalla?
No, ya los puedo ver a todos.
Ah, okay, but ahí están Ana Patricia, Danilo, Hugo,
Andrea Ticas, no sé
Andrea.
Si.
Andrea.
Okay.
No.
Okay,
no.
Okay. Choose a question and ask.
Okay, is music relaxing or stressing?
It's relaxing.
Okay, very good. All right, Andrea, choose one question and ask one of your classmates.
Okay, Danilo. Are women angry or happy?
The woman happy.
Oh, we are happy.
Yes.
Yes, yes. Sometimes, but yes.
Yes.
Okay, very good. All right. Danilo, choose one question and ask another classmate.
Ana Patricia.
Ana Patricia. Okay, very good.
Are flowers beautiful or ugly?
They are beautiful.
They are beautiful. Y si quisiéramos decir, Ana Patricia, las flores no son feas, we say
they are
not.
The flower don't ugly.
Ah, okay.
Don't not ugly.
Siempre vamos a usar el verbo to be. Aquí no podemos usar el don't. Ajá, oh. Entonces vamos a decir they are o they aren't ugly. ¿Ok? Very good. So you say they aren't ugly. They aren't ugly. Ana Patricia, choose one question and ask one classmate.
Juan José.
Oh, Juan Jose, all right.
Okay. Is love necessary or unnecessary?
It is necessary.
Why? Why, Juan Jose? Why is it necessary?
I don't know.
Okay, don't worry. It's necessary. Okay, very good. It is necessary. Okay, thank you very much. Now, we will move to the next activity. And estábamos viendo, ¿se acuerdan? Los adjetivos con preposition. All right. Adjectives with prepositions. For example, todas estas oraciones, todos estos que usted ve acá, todos son adjetivos. They are adjectives. All right, very good. Now, esto lo vamos a usar así. We say, I am. Por ejemplo, voy a escoger uno. I am excited. Okay, excited. Excited is emocionado. So, cuando usted quiere decir, por ejemplo, yo estoy emocionado de, estoy emocionado de ir a la playa, for example. You say, I am excited. La preposición que vamos a decir es about. I am excited about ir. Okay. ¿Cómo se dice el verbo ir, everybody?
Go.
Go. Okay. El verbo ir es go. Pero la regla es que cuando usted ocupa. Exactly. Very good. Alguien se acordó por allí. Very good. So when you say, for example, I'm excited about going to the beach. All right. Very good. I'm excited about going to the beach. This is what you say. Okay, aquí tenemos la combinación. We have the combination here. We have the combination of adjective. No quería este color. I need this color. Okay. Adjective and preposition. Okay, very good. Tenemos adjective and preposition. Siempre vamos a usar. We're gonna always use I am. Okay. Si hablamos de nosotros, I am. Si es de ella, ¿cómo vamos a decir?
She is
excited about going to the beach. Decir oraciones así es un poquito difícil, pero no crean que todas esas vamos a usar. Vamos a escoger algunas. All right, we're going to choose some of them. All right, so you say, I am excited about going to the beach. Teacher, ¿y eso cómo se traduce en español? Yo estoy emocionado de. Ok, emocionado de. The problem is que muchas personas quieren traducir todo literal de español a inglés. Entonces, como de, me pregunto, teacher, ¿y cómo es de es of o de es tú? ¿Cuál es, teacher? Ok, por eso es que están las combinaciones de adjective y preposition. Un adjetivo con su preposición correcta para no andar así como que ¿qué digo? Si digo of, digo tú, digo for, ¿ok? Very good. So, y la regla dice, the rule says that after the preposition, el verbo que usted use tiene que estar con ing. ¿Is it clear?
Yes.
Yes.
¿Está difícil? ¿Is it difficult?
A little bit.
Vale, vamos a ir poquito a poquito. Don't worry. I am patient. Don't worry. Ok. También se pueden hacer oraciones. Aquí abajo les voy a escribir la oración. Pero sin usar el verbo. Sino solo decir, por ejemplo, estoy emocionada por mi nuevo bebé. For example. Imagínese alguien que acaba de ser mamá. O alguien que acaba de ser papá. So you say, I am excited about my new baby. ¿Verdad que no tenemos verbo después de about?
No.
No, ok. Lo podemos poner o no, depende de lo que queramos decir, all right? So you say, I am excited about my new baby. Or I am excited about tener my new baby. Ok, very good, very good. Podemos decirlo de diferentes maneras. Now, vamos a escoger los que vamos a ocupar. Let's see. Ok, de esta columna podemos ocupar angry. Estoy enojado por, I'm angry about. No decimos I'm angry for, all right? I'm angry about. Let's see, happy. I'm happy about. Nervous, nervioso. Sad. Y worried. Eso vamos a ocupar. Ok, very good. No sé si ustedes allá a la mano tienen cuaderno, no.
No.
No, all right. Porque fíjense que si tuvieran a la mano el cuadernito sería mucho mejor, se les va a ir grabando mejor, all right. Si no, pues solo le tomamos la picture. All right, vaya, ahora vamos a practicar. Vamos a tratar de hacer oraciones juntos, all right, together. We're gonna try to make sentences together. Dígame algo por lo que esté feliz ahorita en su vida. Okay.
My son.
Sorry?
My son.
Ah, your son. Okay. Okay. Usted puede decir, I'm happy. I'm happy about having my son. Okay? All right, I'm happy about having my son. Estoy feliz de tener. Teacher, ¿y por qué ha puesto el verbo ahí en, con ing y eso que no es teniendo? No. Después de la preposición, si ponemos el verbo ing es porque es una regla gramatical, pero se traduce tener, así como que si el verbo estuviera en su forma base. ¿Is it clear?
Yes.
Yes. Okay, yes. Is it clear? All right, very good. It's clear. Yo lo voy a llevar poquito a poquito, all right? So you say, I'm happy about having my son. All right, very good. ¿Cómo diría usted, estoy feliz de tener trabajo?
I am happy.
I'm happy.
My work.
So you say, I'm happy about having a job. I'm happy about having a job. Okay? Estoy feliz de tener trabajo. I'm happy about having a job. Is it clear? Is it clear? O está difícil? Is it difficult? Poquito, vaya, vamos a hacer más ejemplo. Vamos a hacer más ejemplo. All right. I'm happy about having a job. Dígame algo que esté feliz de tener, vaya. Solo le borré lo del final. Usted solo diga lo que está ahí. I'm happy about having. I'm happy about having my family. Por ahí alguien dijo my house, right? Or a house. Okay, so you say, I'm happy about having a house. That is good too. I'm happy about having a house too. Okay, because in this moment, having a house is very difficult. Yes or no?
Yes.
Having a house is very, 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 very difficult. Okay, otro voluntario que quiere decir de qué está feliz. De tener qué.
Having a dog, my dog.
Okay, Hugo, all right. Vaya, dígame la oración completa. I'm happy about having.
Happy about having a dog.
Excellent, very good. What's your dog's name?
What?
What's your dog's name?
Goose.
Oh, your dog's name is Goose.
Sí, Goose.
Ah, all right. Okay, very good. Excellent. Okay, another volunteer? Otro voluntario, another volunteer?
Hi. I'm happy about having my new bed.
Excellent. Very good. Do you have a new bed, Carol?
Yes.
So you sleep happily.
I see.
And relaxed.
Sí, ayer sería...
Yesterday.
Yesterday.
Ah, o sea que durmió como bebé.
Ay, sí, me dormí, me levanté más tarde.
Ay, qué galán. All right. Yes, all right, very good. Okay, vaya, vamos a borrar este ejemplo. We're gonna erase this example. All right. And vamos a ocupar otro. Let's see. Let's see, we're gonna use... Nervous. I'm nervous about... Okay. Vaya, dígame algo que lo...
I'm nervous about having... Tonight having a exam.
Ah, you are nervous about having an exam. All right. What exam? English exam?
No, a master.
Oh, you are studying the master's degree?
Yes.
Oh, and you are having an exam when?
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow. So you are nervous about having an exam?
Yes.
Excellent. Very good. Very good, Pamela. Okay. Another example? Rosa Irma is the Pamela.
No problem.
Y ella no me dice nada.
No problem.
Okay, very good. Another example? Otro ejemplo.
Numbers about speaking English.
Ay, okay. Excelente ejemplo. Pero ¿por qué? Why are you nervous? You feel nervous. ¿Qué le da miedo del inglés?
Burla, ¿cómo se dice burla?
Ah, mock.
Mock, the person, mock.
No, no, en este grupo ya vi que no.
No, in English class, no.
Ya. Okay, you mean speaking with other people?
Yes.
¿Ya le ha pasado eso?
Yes.
¿Con quién? ¿Con Americans?
Europea.
¿Y qué le hizo?
Academia Europea.
Yo pensé que una europea.
No, Academia Europea.
¿Y ahí qué le pasó? ¿Que los compañeros se reían o cómo?
Yes.
Ah, mire, si viene de otra persona.
Inmaduros.
Yes, si viene de otra persona que es de nuestra misma nacionalidad, it's like, okay. Si fuera otra persona de otro país, igual no nos tenemos que sentir mal. ¿Ya ha escuchado usted a un americano hablar español?
Yes.
Yo creer ir, y ya viene de regreso.
Yes.
Quiere decir, yo ya voy y dice, yo quiero ir. Yo comí bien rico. Yo quiero comer rico. Y quiere hablar en pasado, right?
Yeah.
Entonces digo yo, si ellos hablan nuestro idioma, sí. Right?
Uh-huh.
Y nosotros nunca les decimos nada. Nosotros hasta chiste nos da. Así que no debemos sentir mal por nada ni por nadie. Ok, very good. Mary, yeah. Aquí tranquila, que aquí... your classmates, ellos son bien tranquilos, ya lo vi, ya los medimos.
Yes.
Son bien tranquilos, and nice. Okay, so you are nervous about speaking English. Okay, very good. Another person? Okay, vaya, vamos a cambiar el adjetivo. We're gonna say sad. Triste, sad. I'm sad about, let's see, okay? Give me an example. I'm sad about waking up early.
Yes.
I think everybody, right? Everybody is sad about waking up early. Okay, very good. All right. Now, tenemos otro de otras categorías. Se lo voy a escoger. All right. I'm gonna choose the category. les voy a escoger uno o dos para que ustedes de tarea me escriban unos ejemplos, ¿ok? Very good. Let's see. Aquí okay. Donde dice for, famous for. Let's see, ready for, responsible for. Ok, ahí le voy a escoger eso. Aquí le vamos a escoger afraid of. Ashamed of. Ashamed es como apenado. Let's see, this one, allergic to. Solo ese le voy a escoger ahí. Y aquí vamos a ver, le voy a escoger este para que se lo aprendan. Fed up. The meaning of fed up es estar harto de. For example, you can say, I'm fed up with, announcements, anuncios de las elecciones. I'm fed up with election announcements or etc. Fed up es estar harto de, right. Let's see, afraid of, este sí lo vamos a practicar aquí. Dígame algo a lo que le tenga miedo. I'm afraid of. Ok, podemos usar un verbo o no podemos usar un verbo. Por ejemplo, le voy a dar yo mi ejemplo. I'm afraid of frogs. Yo soy temerosa a las ranas o sapos. I'm afraid of frogs. Ok, what about you? Everybody?
Opossum. Opossum, creo que se dice. Tacuacín.
Ah, possum. Possums. All right, very good. So you are afraid of possums. Okay, very good. Possums. Another person?
How do you say altura?
Ah, heights.
Pasarela.
Oh, that is the pedestrian bridge.
I afraid of pedestrian bridge.
Oh, you are afraid of pedestrian bridges. Lo vamos a poner en plural.
When I driving, I don't like driving on. No me gusta man.
Ah, you don't like driving under pedestrian bridges.
Yes.
Why? Why because, not?
Because when I was a par piscinas, how do you say toboggan?
Oh, the slide.
The slide I don't like because bueno, lo voy a decir en español porque me subí a un tobogán y por poco me salgo de porque me ubiqué mal y iba como saltando y ya me iba a salir del tobogán. Desde entonces no me gustan las alturas.
Ah, so you don't like heights okay. All right, no, that is dangerous. That is dangerous.
No me gusta ir a los, digamos, a las, a manejar cuando voy, digamos, en un paso de desnivel que esté súper alto, me da miedo como que me voy a salir.
Ah, entonces es paso a desnivel.
Ajá.
Ah, no es el no es la pasarela. All right, so you say, I'm afraid of overpasses.
Overpass.
Ajá. Overpass. Overpass es paso a desnivel.
Ok.
Ah, I understand. Yo estaba tratando de hacer la relación. ok. Now I understand. Ok. Another person. Pablo, what are you afraid of?
I'm afraid of the woman hungry.
All right, you are afraid of angry women.
Women.
Yes. Hey, why? Because yeah. we are angels.
No.
we are angels. We don't have All right, very good. Juan Jose, tell me something you are afraid of.
I am afraid of snakes.
Of snakes. All right, very good. What, de todas or only one?
All the snakes. All
the snakes. All right, very good. Okay. Carol, tell me something you are afraid of.
Los tacuacines.
Ah, usted fue la que me dijo los tacuacines.
Sí, Ana. Las ratas.
And rats. Okay, and rats. Okay. Sara, what are you afraid of?
I am afraid of blow.
You are afraid of?
Blow.
Of blood. You are afraid of blood. Okay, very good. Let's see. Let's see. Ana Patricia, what are you afraid of?
I am afraid of my mom.
Me too. Yes. Luis Fernando, what are you afraid of?
I am afraid of my wife.
You are really. Is your wife angry?
So.
All right, very good. Okay. Everybody, please, tómele una foto a esto y fíjese los que tienen chequecito verde, que son los que vamos a ocupar, all right? Of homework. All right, very good. Ya les voy a decir qué es lo que vamos a hacer with that. Okay, do you have the picture?
Yes.
Okay, very good. Yes. I'm gonna erase this. All right, ahora vamos a borrar esto. I'm gonna erase this. Tal vez alguien la puede mandar al group the picture. Okay, now, en sus manuales de clase, okay, we have other expressions, pero estas ya son más como de para referirnos a trabajo. Por ejemplo, responsible for, este es uno, all right, ser responsable de, in charge of, a cargo de, por ejemplo, aquí dice, who is in charge of, ¿quién está a cargo de, who is in charge of? Responsible for, accountable for, se parece a quien está responsable de, in charge of and accountable for. All right, very good. Now, do you remember, lo que hemos estado viendo es que después de la preposición, el verbo, the verb, tiene que estar en ing. Entonces, ¿cómo sería esta pregunta? Who is responsible for? ¿Cómo sería esa pregunta allí?
Ese verbo.
Very good. El verbo lo vamos a poner en ing. Supervising. Who is responsible for supervising the machine operators? Machine operators are los operadores de máquina, right? Okay, what about the next one? Check. Who is in charge of? ¿Quién está a cargo de? Who is in charge of?
Checking.
Very good. Y ahí dice revisar. Checking. All right. Who is in charge of checking the quality control of the product? The quality of the products. Okay. What about the next one? Who is responsible for?
Repairing.
Very good. Who is responsible for repairing? Repairing. All right. Very good. Who is responsible for repairing? The next one. Who is accountable for?
Selling.
Very good. Selling the products. All right. Very good. The next one. Who is in charge of?
Assisting.
All right, very good. We say assisting. ¿Quién está encargado de
asistir o ayudar a los assemblers, o sea, los que ensamblan, ensambladores. All right. Who is accountable for?
Manager.
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 Or managing.
Managing.
Managing. Who is in charge of managing the whole, la operación completa, the whole operation? Now, sorry for the question, but in su trabajo, in your job, do you have a supervisor?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, okay. Who is responsible for supervising you?
My boss.
Your boss. All right, very good. You can invent a name if you want. Maria, Jose, all right? Who is in charge? Who is in charge of supervising your job? What's the name of the person? Invent el nombre.
Saúl.
Saúl. All right, very. Is your boss angry or no?
No.
No.
No. Yes. Okay. Yes. Okay, very good. No, no, yes. All right, very good. Okay. I'm going to take a picture from this. Le voy a tomar una foto a esto. Para mandárselo, porque imagínense que tenemos un examen. Imagine we have an exam. Imagínense, yo les pongo un examencito así y usted solo va a tener que poner el verbo en ing, ¿ok? Para que tenga una idea. So you can have a little example. Okay, I'm gonna write it here. All right. Ahí se los mandé. Okay. Do you have a question with this? No.
No.
No. All right. Very good. Mientras practiquemos otro poquito más. All right. But that's not a problem. Okay. Very good. Now, here, everybody. Here we have the verb. Uy. Los verbos. ¿Quién se puede más o menos algunos verbos? Can you tell me? ¿Quién se puede más o menos algunos verbos? Some verbs.
I am.
I.
Okay, very good. Now here, aquí tengo un ejemplo de verbos. All right, very good. For example, we have verb to be. Que ya conjugado, ¿cuál es el verbo to be?
Ser.
Am.
I.
Am, are, or is. Very good, very good. Then we have the verb have.
I have.
I have. Very good. Then we have
do.
All right. Es el verbo tener. All right. Very good. Do es el verbo hacer. Say. ¿Qué verbo es say?
Decir.
Decir. Very good. What about go?
Ir.
Ir, very good. What about get?
Obtener.
Obtener.
What about make?
Hacer.
Hacer.
Hacer, very good. Now, los verbos en inglés tienen tres formas. Simple form, que es su forma base, o sea, el verbo está así intacto. Simple past, el verbo en pasado. Y tenemos verbos en pasado participio, past participle verbs, ¿ok? Pasado participio. Es, por ejemplo, usted dice, for example, tener, tuve, tenido, ¿ok? That is like the verb. For example, aquí tenemos el ejemplo del verbo drink. Ok, drink is?
Is present.
Drink is present. Drank is?
Past.
Past. And drunk is? Past participle. Ok, very good. Para que conozcan cómo son los verbos en inglés. Simple present. Simple past. And past participle. Ok, so for example, drink. ¿Cómo lo traduciríamos en español? Drink.
Bebiendo.
Beber. Beber, very good. Beber, very good. All right. So you can say, for example, I drink. You drink. We, nosotros, we drink. Ellos, they, ellos beben. They drink. He, él bebe, he drinks, she drinks, she drinks, it drinks. Ok, tengo una pregunta, everybody. ¿Quiénes han estudiado el presente simple? ¿Quiénes han estudiado el presente simple? No.
So-so.
All right, bye. Ese es otro que se nos va a la lista también. Porque eso es bien importante saberlo. Very important. Así que tranquilo. Si no lo han estudiado, lo vamos a repasar. Entonces, dijimos plural nouns. Esa es una cosa que se nos va a la lista para estudiar. Y present simple. Vaya, estos temas que yo estoy viendo ahorita son los que están en el manual de INSAFORP, right? Very good. Estos están en el manual. Pero si hay otros que reforzar, lo vamos a hacer, ¿ok?
Thank you.
Ok, yes, lo vamos a reforzar. Lo que me interesa es que aprendan bien. That's what I want you to do. Aprender bien. Ok, so drink. ¿Cómo conjugamos un verbo en presente? We say, I drink, you drink, we drink, they drink, he drinks, she drinks, it drinks. Cuando les explique un poquito el presente simple, van a entender por qué el verbo tiene S cuando es he, she, it. Okay, I'm gonna tell you later. What about the verb in past? ¿Cuál es el pasado, el verbo en pasado?
Drank.
Drank, okay, y ese se conjuga así. I drank. You drank, we drank, they drank, he drank, she drank, it drank. ¿Cómo es más fácil conjugar el verbo, en pasado o en presente?
Pasado.
Porque es el mismo para todos los sujetos, yes or no?
Yes.
Very good. Pero oiga en español, listen in Spanish. Yo bebí, tú bebiste, nosotros bebimos, vosotros bebisteis, ellos bebieron, yo, ella bebió. ¿Qué, cómo es más fácil conjugarlo? ¿In English or in Spanish?
In English.
In English, yeah, el mismo verbo es para todo. Pero como nosotros hablamos español, lo vemos fácil. Ahora imagínese un americano aprendiendo español. Nosotros beber. Beber es el verbo en su forma base, right? Pero conjugado, ¿cómo es, everybody? Nosotros
bebemos.
Bebemos in present. Bebimos in past. Beberéis in plural. Oh my God. In future, sorry. So it is. El inglés no es tan difícil, solo es de aprenderse bien los verbos en su tiempo correcto, etc. All right. So we say here. So, ¿cómo sería o cuál ocuparíamos para referirnos a esta foto?
He drank.
He drank. Very good. He drank beer yesterday. Look at the face. ¿Y aquí cómo sería? En presente.
He drinks all night yesterday.
Ah, ok. Pero si decimos yesterday, tiene que ser este. He drank.
He drank.
Este como es de presente, podemos decir esta palabra. Eso poquito a poquito se lo voy a ir explicando. So you say, he drinks every day. Ajá, porque es de todos los días. present, okay? He drinks every day. Yeah, teacher, he drinks every day, and pin el column, all right?
He drinks today.
Ah, okay, he drinks every day. All right, what about the next one? The next one, el siguiente verbo es un pasado participio, okay? And the meaning of this one is bebido. Okay, now, ¿cómo se conjuga este? Es para que ustedes vean la diferencia de tiempos. All right. Aquí vamos a tener que usar un auxiliar, que es un verbo que ustedes ya conocen. I have, okay? Pero en este caso, have no funciona como tener, yo tengo. Funciona como un auxiliar y funciona así. Aquí uno, aquí estamos diciendo, yo he bebido. Yo he bebido. Tú has bebido. Nosotros hemos bebido. Así se ocupa el have en esta estructura. ¿Ok?
Teacher.
Yes.
What different, yes, teacher, what different is have or had?
Sorry?
What different is have or had?
No, no, you say have. Oh. I have.
Sí, perdón. La diferencia porque have, tener, pero también get es de tener.
Yo pensaba que me estaba preguntando de la pronunciación. Vaya, la pronunciación del verbo have, la correcta es decir have. I have. ¿Ok? Pero usted me está hablando de este verbo, del verbo get, de este, ¿verdad?
Get, es correcto.
Ajá, very good. El get significa obtener.
Okay.
I get, all right?
Obtener.
Obtener, very good, okay. Yeah. Pero fíjese que le voy a explicar algo, I'm gonna tell you something. Los norteamericanos utilizan el verbo get para referirse a tener. Por ejemplo, ellos dicen, por ejemplo, ¿y dónde están las llaves? Where are the keys?
I get them.
Entonces ellos dicen, oh, I got them. Yo las tengo. I got them. ¿Ya? Ay, ¿a dónde está el celular? Where's my cell phone? Oh, my God. Oh, don't worry. I got it. Ellos ocupan mucho eso para referirse a yo tengo. I got it. Y si quieren decir, yo tengo un carro, dicen, I got a car. Si quieren decir, yo tengo novia, I got a girlfriend, I got a boyfriend, I got a house, I got a, all right? Pero eso ya es como, como muy cosa de lo que ellos dicen. Pero bueno saberlo, it's good to know.
Thank you. Es informal, teacher.
Yes, it's informal. Yes. It is informal. Pero es lo más utilizado. It is the most common thing. Por ejemplo, quizás no viene el caso lo que le voy a contar, pero es bien importante contarlo. Yo le doy clases de inglés a mi hermana que vive en Texas. Ella no habla inglés y ya tiene 10 años de vivir por allá. All right? So I'm teaching her English. Le estoy enseñando yo inglés, pero a la vez ella me enseña a mí las cosas como reales que ocupan por allá. ¿Ok? Por ejemplo, acá cuando nosotros platicamos, what's your name? Oh, my name is Ana Ruth Gómez Mejía. Okay, what's your middle name? Tu segundo nombre. Oh, my middle name is Ruth. Ella dice que allá solo preguntan first name and last name. That's it. Allá preguntan primer nombre y primer apellido y ya estuvo. No andan preguntando, what's your complete name? What's your middle name? What's your, no. They say, what's your first name? Y ni dicen, what's your first name? Si dice que solo le dicen, first name, oh, Ana. Last name, Gómez, ¿ok? Entonces eso de, I got them, I got it, es bien, bien cosas que ocupan mucho por allá. Pero bueno saberlo, it's good to know. Pero no está incorrecto decir, I have, all right? Oh, I have a dog. Yeah, I got a dog. The two are correct. Pero lo vamos a poner así. One is formal and the other is informal. ¿Ok?
Ok.
Ok, very good. Vaya, vamos a terminar este porque ya casi terminamos. We have drunk. They have drunk. He has drunk. She has drunk. It has drunk. Vaya, ahora. Ese she has drunk es ella ha bebido. Imagínense una amiga de ustedes llega donde ustedes y llega todo así. Hi, Juan José. Juan José.
Hola.
How are you? How are you?
She has drunk.
Ah, hey. La teacher ha tomado. Right? How do you say that in English? ¿Cómo decimos eso en inglés?
She has drunk.
Excellent. You say, hey, the teacher has drunk. ¿Por qué?
She's very, very drunk.
Ah, que no la miras. Look at her. She's like, all right? Okay, very good. Le vamos a tomar foto a esto. Take a picture to this. Y lo mandamos al grupo porque ya se nos acabó el tiempo. Time has gone out. ¿Qué les parece esto que hemos visto ahora? Interesante, ¿verdad?
Interesting.
Yes. Interesting, yes. Pero para eso, for that, necesitamos saber para qué se usa cada tiempo. Este lo vamos a estudiar un poquito más adelante en este módulo, right? In this module. Pero a este sí quiero darle importancia porque es la base de estos otros dos. ¿Ok? Ok. Well, my dear students, thank you very much. Thank you for being here. Gracias por estar por aquí. And I will see you tomorrow. All right? I will see you tomorrow. Gracias por haberme mandado el listening. Ahora tal vez solo vamos a trabajar con las oracioncitas que quiero que me escriban. Si las hacen escritas o in computer, solo voy a pedir que me manden una picture de las oraciones. All right?
All right.
Okay, all right. Very good. Ready. Unas cinco que sean. Yo sé que les marqué más, pero I need only five. Yo sé que su tiempo es cortito. All right. Bye bye. See you tomorrow, everybody.
Bye.
Take care. Bye bye. See you tomorrow. Bye bye.